lot of power, and it makes me feel like that. It makes me feel like that.
Good morning. Good morning, everybody. It is 9:26 a.m. It is time for Uplift with Cliff. I see some people rolling in. I see the eyes popping up. It's 9:30 a.m. It is Monday, September the 21st. Hey, Patty Silva, you're the first today, girlfriend. Hafid Bougie, it is good. Look, there it is, Hafid Bougidi, that's my boy, my brother. Good morning. We're not going to stop till we get enough. It's 9:30 a.m. The Uplifters are rolling in. And I am your humble servant, Cliff Long. Good morning, Anna Gazzara. Good morning, Rose Kemp in the house, the exercise diva. Patty Silva, yes, International Peace Day. Let it roll off your tongue. Say it peace today. Rosie Papagiannakis is in the house today. The people are rolling in. It's going to be a beautiful Monday. Some of you guys can feel it. I know you can feel it. We're getting ready to get started in just a minute. Just a minute. I'm going to let you all have a few more minutes to roll on in. I see you, Rosie Papagiannakis. Hafid, let's do some lifting today. Are you guys excited? How many of you guys are excited? It's going to be a great week. It's going to be an awesome week. Look, I checked high, I checked low. I just looked at CNN USA Today. I looked at Huffington Post, and I looked at Fox News. I checked every link, every ad. I checked everything I could, and I couldn't find it anywhere that this wasn't gonna be your best week ever. I have every indicator, every indication, every inclination, in every situation, every reason to believe that you are gonna have an awesome week. This is Uplift with Cliff. It is 9:32 a.m. by my clock. We're getting ready to get started. This week, we're not gonna stop till we get enough. It's gonna be a great Monday, y'all. I don't know if you feel it. I'm so excited. I'm ready. I could run through walls and leap over buildings today just for you. Just for you. Can y'all feel that vibe? Can you feel it? Can you tell? Kathy Grimes, look at Carlene. Look at Carlene. Lisa Hill's in the house. Precious in the house today. I see you, Rosie. Speak that Greek to me, baby. I love it. Laura Schuler, you're looking awesome. Michael Marsh, Leslie Wilson Van Gotham, my sister right there. Cassie Landry, you're looking awesome. Yolan, woohoo! Cynthia, Jared, they are rolling in this week. Cynthia, it's going to be a great week, Cynthia, and you know it. You just called it. Deidre Allen closed her first deal on Friday. That's uplifting, baby. Tell them, Deidre. Close everybody. Give Deidre that round of applause. She just closed her first deal on Friday. We are getting ready to get started right here. And we're going to get ready to go in deep today, okay? So, is everybody ready? Is everybody ready? Margaret Ann, I see you today. Anna, Cassie, Ashley Wheeler, Lisa. Ooh, Lisa. Yes, I can tell, Lisa. Cynthia DeLuca, my sister. Real estate. Look at Tiffany right there, blowing them away. Will Laval is the man. Guys, we get ready to have the best week ever. Let's get ready to get started, okay? Let's get ready to get started. We're going to fade our music out. And we're going to fade Monday on in. This is your September 21st, I almost said July, September 21st edition, hey Elaine, of Uplift with Cliff. And the Uplifters are lifted up today. Listen, to start today's edition, I have got to give a huge shout out. Listen, Y'all know we do this for each other, the Uplifters. This is not about Cliff. It's not about anyone else. I tell people all the time, hey, good morning, Dan Lopez in the house. As long as I've got people out there who are willing to help other people, who are ready to have their best week ever, who are willing to do something special for somebody and help lift them up, I will stay on this broadcast forever. Curtis Grimes, you ready, baby? So today, before I get into something special that I want to talk to you about, we're going to kick it off with a very special shout out to Jeffrey Reyes. If you know Jeffrey, let Jeffrey know, good job. Jeffrey sent me this message over the weekend. He said, I just spoke with a lady whose brother committed suicide. We prayed and we talked. He said, I was grateful to be able to listen to her story and let her share her pain. Listen, Jeffrey Reyes, that's what life is all about, baby boy. That's what this is all about. Sitting down with somebody who's hurting. That's why I do this. This is why I talk to every new member orientation class. I don't want anyone to feel like they gotta go it alone. You have somebody next to you. I see you, Chi-Chi. Yes, Curtis. Yes, Lindsay. Jeffrey, you're gonna get a big, big, big uplift with Cliff's shirt and a goodie bag from ORRA today for being there for somebody else, for putting yourself aside and lifting somebody else. Juan Sosa, good to see you. Awesome job, Jeffrey. So today, Cliff, what do you have in store for us? This is a big shout out to all you people out there who have given yourself all you have to your jobs. You've given all you have to your family. You've given all you have to your friends. But you lost track of who you were. You see, the funny thing about adulthood, the funny thing about being mom, the funny thing about being dad and husband, is you go hard in the paint, you do so much for so many other people, you actually lose sight of who you are in the process. You lose sight of that little girl that thought she was going to be a millionaire, and that little boy who thought he was going to be an astronaut. You start grinding so hard. Good morning, Berlisa. Yes, you start working so hard, you lose your life in the process. So today's Uplift with Cliff is all about those uplifters who've given all they had to a job, to a business, to a relationship, to something or someone else, but they lost track of themselves. Today, this week, your best week ever, I want to help you find yourself again in the midst of the chaos. We're going to uplift ourselves today because you got to be able to uplift yourself before you can uplift somebody else. Boom, I just blew your mind. You got to be able to uplift yourself before you can uplift somebody else. So today, we're going to talk about five things you can do to find yourself again. Five things you can do to find yourself again. This is about rediscovering who you are. The person who you are now is the person they created. What I want today, the person I want to see today, is the person that was there long before there was a Cliff, long before you knew anything about being a CEO or a realtor or a politician. I want that old person to come back out and shine so that you can be happy again. So you've got two choices to make, uplifters. Good morning, Reese Stewart. Good morning, Andrew. You've got two choices you can make. The first choice you can do is to choose to do nothing and continue to wander around in darkness. Continue to be unhappy every day of your life. Continue to always be living through somebody else, but never living through yourself. You got that choice. As a matter of fact, some of y'all are doing it right now. I want to break that up. The second thing you can do, you can either wander around and do nothing, or you can choose to find yourself again and take back control of your life and get rid of those fears. How many of y'all want option number two? I'm choosing option number two today. Hey, we've sat around and did nothing all our lives. It's time for you guys to take back your life, take back the and find the person that you lost. So today's Uplift with Cliff is about rediscovering who you are in five ways, five things that you can do this week to get the old you back. Not feeling yourself, not feeling like the usual you, society stole it away, situations stole you away, divorce stole you away, new job stole you away, needing some gas money stole you away. Well, it's time to refind yourself. Good morning, Steve Bell and Clarence. It's time, Michelle, for you to uplift yourself because you got to be able to uplift yourself before you can uplift anybody else. So if you're lost, many of you have lost sight of your true beauty. You've forgotten just how beautiful you are. You've forgotten just what a special person you are. You're wandering around out there being who society told you you were. You can no longer do that. Some of us are 50, 60, 70 years old. You got to rediscover who you are. We got to come out of that. So the first thing that I want you to do today, the first thing I want every uplifter to do today, you ready? Here we go. We're getting into the meat of it. Stop believing every toxic thought that you have. You have to stop believing every toxic thought that you have. If you want to find yourself again, if you want to rediscover who you are, you have to stop believing every toxic thought that you have. You see, the thoughts, those thoughts that you have, the ones in the dark, the ones at night, the ones when nobody's around, the ones when you're sitting in your car, the ones when you're wondering if you should go inside and make that pitch, those thoughts are killing you. You've got to stop believing every toxic thought that you have. Those thoughts tell you you're not good enough. You'll never be good enough. They tell you that you're a failure and you're always going to be one. Your mom was a failure. Your dad was like that. You'll never be like these people. You should have never been born. I know people who have thoughts that say they should never been born, totally skipping over the fact that they have a glorious purpose on this earth. But they listen to those thoughts that say I should have never been born. And then the world doesn't need you anyway. Don't listen to that. Listen, the first thing I need you to know, every uplifter, is you are normal. Everyone has toxic thoughts. Even I have toxic thoughts. There are things about me that I have insecurities about that I just don't share, but I never let them take root. I never let them get any deeper than a shallow thought, because once it gets beyond your mind and into your heart, you're a goner. Don't ever let those shallow thoughts make it out of your mind. You gotta cast them out early. So you got to stop believing every toxic thought that you have. If you want to find yourself again, you got to remember that these negative and toxic thoughts are not the definition of who you are as a person. You are so much greater. You are wonderful. You're fearfully and wonderfully made. You are so beautiful. You're beautiful in my eyes. You're beautiful in so many other people's eyes. Stop listening to these toxic thoughts. You are the most beautiful woman I've ever seen. You're the most handsome guy I will ever meet. That's who you are. That's who you've got to believe you are. You know what we will do instead? Imagine yourself in a room full of 1,000 people. We can be in a room full of 1,000 people and 999 people will come up to you and tell you how awesome you are. 999 people will tell you how beautiful you are. 999 people will tell you that you're the greatest. And then one person can come up and tell you, you ain't nothing, you'll never be nothing, and your daddy wasn't nothing. And you would bypass all 999 other people and listen to that one jerk that doesn't know anything about you. And now all of a sudden, you're building toxic thoughts off of that one jerk. You gotta cut that crap. Today, I'm here to tell you that you are absolutely beautiful. You're wonderful. And that one person that tore you down was thinking that about themselves, and they just shared their inner thoughts about themselves and heaped it on you. They told you how they feel about themselves. See, I know when ugly people come up to me wanting me to feel bad, all that ugliness they got inside, I know it when I see it. And I don't let them heap that ugliness on me. I give them about, when I feel down, I give myself 24 to 48 hours to think through this thing. And then I remember that they wasn't there when I was broke. They wasn't there when I was lonely. They wasn't there when I was climbing. They wasn't there when my lights wasn't on. They wasn't there when I couldn't pay my car bill. Why are you here now? Lose me with that. I am great today. This is gonna be my best day ever. Thoughts become things. Good morning, Chris Anderson. I will never. Yes, Claudia. Misery loves company. You got to get those toxic thoughts out of your head, because you are the best thing I will meet all week. You are the greatest person I will meet all month. And I absolutely love you, and so many other people do too. The second thing. Taking back control, remembering who you are. You've lost yourself. You've lost yourself in your job. You lost yourself in being a parent. You lost yourself in being all these things. We're finding who we are today. The second thing you've got to do is remember this. You don't have to, good morning, Natalie Aerosmith. You don't have to control everything around you. Some of you guys are such big control freaks, and you can't let go. And so trying to control everything around you is really breaking up who you are and not allowing your personality. I see you, Heather, not allowing your personality, the true personality, to shine through. You see, I learned a long time ago that I'm best when I'm thinking on my feet. I don't worry about controlling circumstances and scripting things out. I believe that it's going to work in my favor. Do you believe it's going to work in your favor? I wake up believing it's going to work in my favor. I want you guys today to, yes, stop believing the lie. I want you to stop trying to control everything. Let life give you its ebbs and flows. Let life direct you sometimes in that new direction, because you're going to rediscover that there's something out there for you that you never considered. I need you to understand today, Uplifters, and help other people understand that life has a natural flow that's happening all around you. Sometimes you feel the need to control this instead of just letting it flow naturally. Listen, and when you become imbalanced like that, that's what causes the disconnection. Because when you think you can't control all of these things, you become disconnected. And what happens next? After disconnection comes loneliness. Once you start feeling like you're out of control and you disconnect, and then here comes loneliness. And let me tell you something, ladies and gentlemen, the first sign of depression is isolation. The first sign of depression is isolation. So, yes, Deidre, you got to speak it into existence. Curtis, you got it. Heather, you got it. Chris, absolutely. So, what are we going to do today? Stop trying to control everything around you. Let your life take its course. You got to go back to being who you were, who you were created to be, because you, yes, you, realtor, yes, you, CEO, yes, you, politician, yes, you, husband, yes, you, photographer. There's so many people here. You are absolutely awesome. You are made the way you're supposed to be made. There is nothing wrong with you. Get those toxic thoughts out of your head and stop trying to control everything. We're taking back our life today. It's 9:43 a.m. and this is the 21st of September, Uplift with Cliff. So the next thing I want you to do, now this one is a big one, because you're watching me on social media or you're watching me on YouTube. Either way it goes, this third one is a biggie. This is about taking back control of our life. The third thing I need you to do today is to reinforce your personal values. Reinforce your personal values. Remember, our ability to communicate with billions of people on a daily basis on YouTube or Facebook or Twitter or Instagram or whatever, TikTok, that ability to create and communicate with a billion people has created a communication overload in your brain. You don't know it. You think you're in control. You think you're controlling it, but you're not. This is why so many people are depressed. This is why so many people are creating suicide. You have communication overload and you can't handle it. And so what's happening is, even when we are sure of ourselves, follow me now, even when we are sure of ourselves and what we believe, then you encounter family and friends and then random strangers on Facebook, on Instagram, on other media, and you start, and they believe something else, and doggone it, if you don't start believing something else too, you were firm on who you were. You were firm on what you believe. Then you clicked on an article on MSNBC. You clicked on something on Fox. You clicked on something and read some crap somebody put out there that's a bunch of hogwash, and you started changing your beliefs in the process. All of a sudden, you pro everything. You pro this, you pro that, you pro this. All of a sudden, you anti everything. I'm anti this, anti that, knowing good and well everybody in your family is doing everything you anti against. Well, because you're like a dandelion blowing in the wind, you no longer have your personal values because you have information overload. Boom! Who you are is now gone. You've lost track of who you are. You've lost track of what's going on because you let the internet steal your peace. You will quickly lose yourself in a sea of doubt when you feel like you're the only one who has certain feelings. When you start feeling like you're isolated, like you're the only one who feels like this, well, can I be Democrat and have some Republican values? Well, can I be Republican and have some libertarian values? When you start thinking you're the only one, guess what? You close up and you be quiet. And then you stop being vocal about the things that are that matter to you. You stop being vocal about what's important to you. And guess what? The real you starts getting smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller and smaller. And then the one that society created, the one you really don't know who in the heck that woman or that man is getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger, and you lost who you were. You got what you want, but you lost who you had. Listen, you've got to stand up for your values even when other people don't stand with you. You cannot compromise your values to become what other people want you to be. Yolan, you got that. Lisa, you got that. You've got to stay focused. Know who you are. Let me tell you something. I'm not going to deviate into politics, but I don't want any of my uplifters to be bound today by society. I am absolutely here to tell you 100% unequivocally, without a shadow of a doubt, just as sure as this is water, that you can have viewpoints that are both Democratic and Republican. Don't let people herd you into a corner politically when you know you love people and you know that you see things differently. Be who you are. Don't let politics and TV dictate who you are. Stand up for your values like Claudia is saying. Doc, you know this. You can have values on both sides of the aisle. Today, I don't want none of my uplifters to get pushed all the way to the right or pushed all the way to the left and become somebody that you're not. And you lose track of who you are, and now you no longer stand up for who you are because you're so busy being who you think they want you to be. And they're fake. They're fake as heck. While they're espousing this and that values, their daughter's sons on TV getting arrested, their people doing this and that, and you're up here trying to live some ideal. The only person getting played is you. Stop it today. Find who you are today. Rose Kemp, I got that, sister. Be you. So that was the third thing. I got to move on because time is flying today. Now, number four is very important. The fourth thing I need you all to do today is give yourself time to breathe. Give yourself time to breathe. We live in a society that expects instant gratification. Everything can't be instantly gratifying. I see Horatio Vincent, my old college roommate, my old buddy from Alabama State University. I see you. Good morning, Horatio. Give yourself time to breathe. Listen, when you can't think of a question to an answer, what do you do today? You Google it. You want to pay something right now? You whip out a credit card. You tapping credit cards today. We started off swiping. Then we was pushing the chip in. Now we just tapping it. And then some of y'all doing Apple Pay. Everything in your life is instant gratification. You want to purchase something, you go straight to Amazon and you look at that due date. And I'm not going to even talk to y'all about expectation. That's another uplift. You look at that due date and you want to hear tomorrow by 8 a.m. All of your life is all about instant gratification. But let me tell you one thing, all my uplifters out there, all my thousands of people out there, you can't use Google to find yourself. That's right. When you get lost and you forget who you are, try to Google who you are and see if you can find yourself. You ain't gonna find yourself on Google. You ain't gonna Bing it. You ain't gonna Yahoo it. And for some of y'all private people, you're not gonna DuckDuckGo it either. The only way that you're going to find yourself and find who you are is to take a minute and breathe, pull back from everything in your life, and chill for a minute. Stop listening to those toxic thoughts. Don't let other people tell you who you are. You're going to have to pull back, find some quiet time, and just breathe. Listen. Back in the day, parents used to give children time out. Well, the purpose of timeout is it wasn't just punishment. It was the ability to go into a corner and think about what you just did and think about what you were going to do. I'm here today to tell you, I want you guys this week, I saw Rose talk about it earlier, you all need some self-imposed time out. Pull away. Because Amazon can't deliver to you a life. You can't eBay a life and you can't Google and find yourself who you are. Happiness comes from within. Like Barlisa says, and you're going to need a little time out. Back away from that situation. Think about it a little while and then come back to it. Michelle, you got that right, sister. You ain't gonna find yourself on Google. What you will find is what other people wrote about you, what other people think about you, and what other people say about you. But you're not gonna find you on Google. You gotta find yourself using these methods that I'm teaching you today. Curtis Grimes, you're right. Self-reflection is key. Number five. I'm coming down the home stretch right here. To find yourself again, to re-identify who you are, to find out what's important to you, the number five thing that I want you all to do this week is to reclassify your wants versus your needs. Yes, Arlene, you got to unplug. I need you guys to reclassify your wants versus your needs. You see, a lot of you guys out there are chasing things and things and things and things. You want a man, you want a car, you want a house, you want some clothing. You got all these wants going on in your life, and they're causing you to lose track of who you are and who you're supposed to be, and you're no longer following and pursuing your needs. Wants versus needs this week. All the uplifters, help everybody out there. Wants versus needs this week. We've been told so often by advertisers and businesses and friends that we need certain things. The reality is you've been misinformed about what you need. Many of those are just things, but what you need are the basics of life. Oh, I'm coming down. I'm going to step on some toes here now. What you need are the basics of life. That's food, water, health, shelter, clothing, and companionship. Wait a minute. Did Cliff just say companionship? I sure did. I didn't say a husband or a wife, but no one should ever be alone. No one on this earth should ever be alone. The things that you need in this life, food, water, health, shelter, clothing, and companionship. Those are the things you need. Everything else you're chasing is a want. Put it in order. See, you got to get back and put your life in perspective. List the things you have in your life as wants and needs. List the things that you have in your life as wants and needs. Some of y'all, ladies, you're going to find out that that man that you got, you just want him, but you don't need him. Oh, gosh. I'm on fire right now. I might have to pour a little water on my head. I'm on fire. Sometimes you're going to find out, fellas, that that lady you have in your life, you just want her, but you don't need her. They're really not doing you any good. Sometimes the company you with, you just want to be with that brokerage, but that's not the brokerage that you need. You probably need someone else who can help you if you're weak on listing agreements and you're weak on sales and you're weak on closings. But this brokerage say he's going to give me this or this. Honey, that's just what you want. But what you need is somebody that's going to sit down and teach you how to do a listing appointment. What you need is somebody that's going to teach you how to fill out a contract. What you need is somebody that's going to stop selling you those phony leads and help you learn how to prospect for real, for real. That's what you need. But what you got is that glamorous brokerage that everybody looks like they driving Mercedes and Bentleys and stuff. And so you up there paying desk fees you can't afford, paying for leads that you can't close, and you wondering what's going on in your life. Caliente. Caliente, Cliff is in fuego. Gracias, mi Rose. Yes. This week, classify your wants versus your needs. Sit down and look at what's going on in your life. Eliminate some of these wants and duplicate some of the needs, and you're going to find happiness again. That's right. It's 9:57 a.m., and y'all know I try to stay on time because I respect your schedules. So the last thing, hey, it's on my piece of paper. I'm not making this up. It's really number six. We're going to use positive affirmations. Y'all see that? That's really the last thing on this list. I know y'all thought I was just trying to get y'all to do some more affirmations. I wasn't. Number six on the list is we're going to do some affirmations. How many of you guys remember that movie with Dan Aykroyd? It was called What About Bob? Any of you guys remember What About Bob? The title in What About Bob, the title character was told by his psychiatrist that that the best way that he needed to get where he was going was to take baby steps. And Bob was baby steps, baby steps, baby steps. Y'all remember baby steps? Baby steps, baby steps. And he was using positive affirmation. I see you, Escarita. I got your message. Bob was using positive affirmations and to cause him to believe that he could do what he was trying to do. He was always reaffirming, baby steps, baby steps, baby steps. Well, through these positive affirmations, he changed his mindset and he was able to get on a bus and do a whole lot of other things. Well, today, this is why we always close out with positive affirmations. So y'all know it's time. It is 9:59 a.m. on this 21st of September version of Uplift with Cliff. And I got to go. I got a whole meeting that I got to get to. But not before we do some affirmations. Today, I want you to look at that. Look at yourself. Look at this screen. I want you to say to yourself, I will never quit. That's right. Say it to yourself. I will never quit. Say, you can't beat me and I will never quit. This week, Uplift with Cliff, positive affirmations. I need you to say it to yourself. Say, life won't beat me and I will never quit. You see, the only way you can lose is if you quit. Say, life won't beat me and I will never quit. To the last breath, to the last thought, we're gonna fight, fight, fight. Life won't beat me and I will never quit. I need you to say, I am fearfully and wonderfully made. That's right, Doc. I am fearfully and wonderfully made. I am fearfully and wonderfully made. God loves me and I love God. God loves me and I love God. I need you to say it to yourself. You got to believe it. You got to believe it before I can believe it. I need you to say, I am an awesome realtor and I will have closings this week. I am an awesome realtor and I will have closings this week. Say it to yourself. Siri even said it. Say, I am an awesome realtor and I will have closings this week. Say, I am a great father and my children love me. I am a great father and my children love me. Say it. I am a great mother and my children love me. I need you to speak some listings into your life. This week, I will have two new listings. This week, I will have two. I need you to define it, define it, define it, define it. If it's not two, it's four. If it's not four, it's eight. If it's not eight, it's 16. But you got to say it so that you have something that you're going after. This week, I will add three new clients. This week, I will add three new clients. Define clients to you. I've got people out there who are coaches listening. I got people out there who work with special needs children. I got people who are politicians. I got people who are CEOs. I need you to define, this week I will have three new clients. Say it. Speak it into existence. Set a personal goal. I see you, Reese. I need you to say it to yourself, I'm the best you ever met. Y'all know that's the signature. I'm the best you ever met. I'm the best you ever met. And then I want you to say it to yourself. Say, I got this. I got this. Say it. Say it. I got this. Say it. I love life and life will reward me. I love life and life will reward me. You got to say it. It's that time. It's that time. I know. I hate to say it, but y'all know it's time to go. It is now 10 o'clock a.m. on this Monday's Uplift with Cliff. Remember, everything that you went through today, everything that we learned today, everything that we talked about today, it is to be shared with somebody else. So if you like today's message, if it resonated with you, and if you think you are willing and can help somebody else out there, I need you to look at that computer right now, look at that phone right now, look at that iPad, hit share to your page, and find that special friend who needs to hear this message. This has been Uplift with Cliff. Another manic Monday. Hey, but you got this. How many of y'all remember the Bangles? Can y'all go back to the 80s with me? What y'all know about Manic Monday? Claudia Jenkins, I love you. Shaniqua, you are the best they ever made. Margaret Ann Jones Gay, you are awesome. Berlisa, thank you all the way from Panama. I'm coming to see you in March. Me and my new president. Horatio, you have an abundantly blessed day. Doc, Rose, yes, Rose. Listen, Doc, I buy houses. Mel, all right, Mel, I like that. Frank McManus, you're the most awesome one. Claudia, Curtis, Heather Hurry. Listen, this week you're going to have two new listings. You got this. Don't you quit. Don't you quit. Heather, don't you quit. Curtis, don't you quit. I'm here to tell you, this week gets easier. This life gets easier. These moments get easier. Good morning, Polly. Good morning, Susan West. Good morning, Curtis. Matthew Limonakis, you're the man. Don't you quit. Pam Tucker, it gets easier, sis. Lisa Eichenblatt, it gets easier, sis. Precious, don't quit. Nobody, don't ever quit. Listen, this Manic Monday, you got it beat. I got to get ready to go to my next meeting. I got to get ready to go. Okay. So, real quick. Hold on. Real quick. I lost my place here. Let's leave on some prints, okay? All right. I still got a lot of folks signed on for some reason. Why y'all still signed on? You not ready to go yet? We still got a lot of people signed on. Okay. I'll give 5 more shout-outs, maybe 10 more shout-outs. 10 more shout-outs, and then I gotta go. Sharif, good to see you, my brother. Shaniqua and Claudia, Coratio, I love you, bro. Michelle Colbert, you the man, you the woman, I should say. Anna, hey, listen, the fitness page is Orlando Realtors Getting Fit. Orlando Realtors Getting Fit. Go join that page. We're gonna start posting our exercise as we work out together. We're gonna do this as a community. Orlando Realtors Getting Quit Fit. Thank you, Anna. Doc, love you. Okay, now for real, I gotta go. Okay, just so you know, as Prince says, I would die for you. It's been up with Uplift with Cook. Hey, how about 10 more people have signed on since I said we're gonna close? Nesper, look at Nesper. No, that's right, Nesper. Okay, Juan Sosa. Elaine, no, you're the best. I'm just a servant. You're the best. You keep on doing what you do so I have a reason to be here. Frank McManus. Frank said it. Don't forget to vote. You got a text message. You got an inbox. You got an email. Vote today for your ORRA leaders. It's time to vote for the ORRA board of directors. Rose Kemp says, join the fitness page. I like that, Rose. I just like that. ORRA Orlando Realtors Getting Fit. Go to the fitness page. I want to see you work out. Join the community. Affirmation. Listen, that's Reese Stewart right there, y'all. Best CEO ever. And if I didn't tell you that Reese loves you, Reese loves you. Thomas Wheeler, you can't always get away. Okay, I'm getting ready to sign off. I'm 6 minutes late. I gotta go to a meeting. I love you. And remember, thoughts become things. Goodbye.